Hey. Come on, party's over. Let's go. Hey. Dora? Perfect. Hey, Dora, come on, wake up. Wake up! I don't believe in sleeping together the first date, okay? Especially when you didn't show up for it. Come on. Dora? Hey. Come on, Dora, wake up! Please? Wake up! All right, I got you. Come on, let's go. Sorry, that's all I got.
What's her name?
Dora Diamond.
How long has she been unconscious?
I don't know. I just found her like that.
Do you know what drug she's ingested?
All I found was beer cans.
Are you a relative?
No. When I got home, she was like that. Some friends had a party.
Nice party.
Put my glasses on because it actually does look like hair growing there.
And all Ron does is spray this. Ron, what if...
Home bald sucks.
You say it comes from your mother.
My mother's got hair, you know.
Yeah, of course she does. Is she okay?
She's stable. We pumped her stomach just to be sure. If she took Rohypnol, she'll be out for another 8 hours. Now, the problem is, on her student emergency card, she has Professor Alcott as her next of kin. You wouldn't happen to know where her parents are or if she's insured?
No, I don't know. Did you call Professor Alcott?
He doesn't know her, and we can't keep her here.
Well, I can take her. I'm her boyfriend.
I thought you just found her like this.
Well, yeah, I did. And boy, was I angry.
Okay. Just fill this prescription.
Great.
Hey, man of my word or what?
Hey, what the heck went on here?
I just came by to help you clean up.
Oh, and I suppose you don't have any idea about Dora?
No, who is that?
The girl who almost had an OD in the bathroom.
She almost OD'd?
Yeah. I came home, I found her passed out, and I took her to the hospital.
Shut up. All right, where is she?
Hey, man, what kind of drugs were you giving out here?
Drugs? Man, all we had was beer. Yeah, no
one... You can't pass out from beer.
Yes, you can, if you take something before you drink it. Her?
What do you mean, oh, her?
Adam found her at a liquor store looking for a party, and the last time I saw her, she was all over Noah, so God only knows what she took before she got here.
It's impossible.
Why is that impossible, man? You know these bridge and tunnel girls? I mean, they sleep around to avoid the commute.
Well, we were going to the concert. She never showed up.
I'm gonna help you out with this, okay, dude? All right. We're gonna do this again next Friday. And I'm gonna hook you up with a nice girl, the kind of girl that you deserve. Now, what are we gonna do with her?
She just has to sleep it off, rest a couple of days.
Okay, what about her parents?
I don't know. She put Professor Alcott as her in case of emergency person.
What's that all about?
I don't know.
Hey, I'm gonna get out of here. And, you'll call me if you need anything.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, Einstein, you can't sleep while you tan. Look at you, you're all burnt.
The tan is underneath, man. I have many layers.
So what's this genius plan you've devised?
Oh, okay, listen to this. We figure out which class we're doing worst in, and we drop it. Then we transfer him to European Lit 101, but it has to be Professor Alcott's class. That way we dump a D and transplant it with an A.
And
why is Alcott suddenly giving us all A's?
Yeah.
I'm gonna make him an offer he can't refuse.
All right, all right. Hey, quiet, you guys.
Hi.
Oh, good morning.
How long have I been asleep?
Since Friday night.
Oh, my God. I've been in your bed and everything.
Oh, it's no problem. Can I ask you something?
Yeah, sure.
Are you on any special medication?
No.
Did you have a lot to drink?
No. I was at a convenience store applying for the night shift job, and there was this guy there, and he told me about this fundraiser that he was having, and he brought me back here. And I drank some juice. I don't really remember much after that. You know, I think somebody slipped me a roofie or something.
Boy, I have got to stop trusting people. You want some lunch? Yeah, you do. You haven't eaten in days. I'm starving. I ate this morning. What do you say?
Hey, when you took me to the hospital, did they call anybody to come get me?
No. They said you were okay to go home and rest a couple of days and drink plenty of liquids. Oh, and you need to take these.
Charcoal?
Mm-hmm. So I can start a fire in your heart. All right, that'll be ready in just a minute. You just lie back and veg, as you young people say. And I will read the plague so we don't fall behind in lit class. You know, I don't know about you, but I really need a B plus in Alcott's class.
Uh-oh, Alcott hates neediness. You know how old he is? He's only 34 and he's been a full professor for almost 10 years. He was the youngest in the history of the university.
So I can be on the final?
Look, I'm sorry. I should have told you that he was my boyfriend.
We've been together all semester. I just wish they would have called him instead of causing you all this trouble.
Oh, no, hey, it's, it's no trouble. I enjoy having you here.
Yeah, but I've been asleep.
Yeah, well, I guess it's a good thing I'm easily amused, right?
Why are you so nice?
Hey, buddy.
Yo, 420 later.
Yo, gonna see you Friday, right?
All right. Professor Alcott, I need to talk to you about Dora.
I'll cut you the same deal as I cut the others.
Sir, the thing is, she's at my place, and she had her stomach pumped because she was given some drugs, and she's been really sick all weekend, and her file, it lists you as her in case of emergency
look,
person.
Look,
Paul.
Paul. Miss Diamond has kind of like this schoolgirl crush on me. You know how they can build these entire relationships up in their head. It's great of you to be so concerned.
Sir, I don't think you understand.
No, I understand, okay? I understand. I get it. It's fine. We'll work it out, okay?
Sir,